text messaging has changed the way we communicate forever. Since its inception in 1992, the ubiquitous short message service, or SMS, is responsible for sending trillions of messages between cell phones every year. Its impact on society has been undoubtedly positive. This year is SMS's 33rd birthday. Despite its age and ubiquity, I think it's time we dropped SMS and moved on to something better. Here's why. One of the biggest issues with SMS is that it's such an outdated technology. SMS hasn't changed much since its inception in 1992. It's like sending a postcard. Anyone along the way can read the contents of your message because it's not encrypted. You might think that when you send an SMS, it goes directly to someone's phone, but that's not the case. SMS operates as a store and forward service. When you send an SMS, it's sent to a short message service center, which then forwards the message to the destination number. This is done to ensure the message can still be delivered even if the recipient's phone is offline. However, this process opens you up to having your messages and their metadata stored by your telecommunications provider. Telecom providers collect a wealth of personal data, such as call logs, SMS content, location data, and browsing history. This data is monetized through various means. Telecoms often share anonymized or aggregate user data with third-party companies for market research and advertising purposes. By analyzing user behavior, telecoms can profile individuals and deliver targeted advertisements. In some instances, telecoms may sell user data directly to data brokers, who then package and resell it to different industries. In 2022, the Salt Typhoon hack exposed the vulnerabilities of traditional telecommunications infrastructure. Hackers exploited vulnerabilities in telecom systems to gain access to sensitive information, including call records, SMS messages, and location data. This incident underscored the urgent need for more secure communication methods. Due to the widespread adoption of SMS, many websites and service providers now employ two-factor authentication via SMS to safeguard their users' accounts. This enhances security compared to a standard password, but it can be more easily circumvented than other secure two-factor authentication methods. This is accomplished through a SIM swapping attack, where a malicious actor reaches out to your telecommunications provider and impersonates you. They then transfer your phone number to a SIM card they possess, enabling them to intercept all your communications and gain access to accounts associated with your phone number. In many countries, obtaining a phone number requires providing personal identification. This links your identity to your phone number, making it easier for authorities and your cell provider to track who you're communicating with. How long have you had your current phone number? Probably a long time, right? This is another issue with SMS and phone numbers. They're a static identifier that doesn't change. There are only a certain number of phone numbers that are available, so even if you're careful and your number hasn't been breached, you're still vulnerable to smishing attacks. This is where nefarious actors will bulk send messages to chunks of numbers to try and trick people into compromising their information, device, or accounts. On top of these concerns, in large parts of the world, SMSs aren't free and unlimited and cost money to send. Using an alternative to communicate that's free is a no-brainer considering all the downsides of SMS. Securing your communications has never been easier. One of the largest problems with SMS is that it doesn't offer any sort of end-to-end encryption between recipients. End-to-end encryption means that your communication is secured from your phone to the recipient's phone. This means that no bystander like your telecom provider or the government can read or intercept your messages. It works by encrypting the message on your device before sending. Only the recipient has the ability to decrypt the message. The good news is, SMS is slowly being replaced. Rich Communication Services, or RCS, is a new standard that seeks to replace the outdated SMS protocol. Should you consider using that instead? RCS addresses several of SMS's shortcomings, such as enabling the sending of high-resolution images, reactions, and typing indicators. However, while the Google Messages app supports RCS encryption, It's limited to Android devices with Google Play services. The standard is still in development, and an interoperable standard is being worked on to enable encryption between all Android and iOS devices in the future. But this is why we still recommend using a separate messaging app that prioritizes privacy and security. Signal is a direct replacement for SMS that uses your phone number for contact discovery, but keeps your conversations encrypted and private. It operates like similar messaging apps like WhatsApp and Telegram, but has state-of-the-art encryption to ensure only you and your recipient have access to message content. Signal offers an advanced feature called Sealed Sender, which enables users to send and receive messages without Signal being able to trace the origin of the message except for the intended recipient. The static identifier of SMS enables your communications provider to identify the recipient of your messages. SimpleX Chat addresses this issue by eliminating static identifiers, instead using a temporary address to facilitate communication between users. Since telecommunications providers are centralized entities where SMS messages flow, SimpleX employs a decentralized network of relay servers to ensure that no single entity gains visibility into your communications. Remember, you can always find our latest instant messenger recommendations at privacyguides.org. Privacy isn't just about making personal changes. It's about spreading the message to your friends and family. A secure messenger is useless without someone else to use it with. So share this video with them, so they can also learn why they should ditch SMS and move to more secure and private alternatives. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, please consider subscribing. This video wouldn't be possible without the generous support of our sponsors. If you want to support our mission of defending digital rights and teaching people how to protect their privacy, please consider donating at the link in the description.